Kasuto explained that the government should have a tax framework on how the agriculture sector can benefit from oil and gas.
For us, especially at the EAN Economic Association, is that it's not necessarily to say that oil and gas is going to directly impact, you know, the reduce your food imports, but definitely the taxes that are derived, the royalties that are derived from there. Government should have a very responsible and focused framework that speaks to how do we do that, how do we empower private sector to participate, whether it's through PPPs, within the agricultural sector, in order to aid the reduction of our food imports.
Kasuto said tourism numbers have gone up since the emergence of oil and gas in the country. He emphasized the importance of a logistics base that supports agriculture.
What that comes with is logistics and a logistics base. Agriculture, for it to be effective in any country, it's important that we move towards, you know, mechanization, but logistics is a very key component. Cold storage facilities, all the areas, these can be supplementary in terms of being able to say, well, Namibia can be ready to be able to, given our small population, produce enough food for itself, but be able, in order for that industry to be sustainable, to be able to export, right? And in order to export, you need certain infrastructure and a logistics base that's there. And that, those are probably some of the forward and backward linkages that we're talking about.
The conference adds value to a knowledge gap in the private sector, government, and people on the ground.